Ion nitriding is a diffusion process in which nitrogen is introduced into the crystal structure of the material and increases the hardness, wear resistance and fatigue life of the tools and parts. Okay, but what exactly does this mean? Let's start from the beginning. To explain the concept, let us take these gears, made out of steel, and look into them. Steels are made of iron and a small amount of carbon, alloying elements such as chromium, manganese, silicon, molybdenum, nickel and others are usually added in order to increase the properties of the steels, like strength, durability, machinability, corrosion resistance and so on. These gears, that we will look into, are made of steel grade AISI 4142. And they have some of the mentioned alloying elements. We will zoom in all the way to the atomic level and to a single atom. In steels, atoms are packed together closely, arranged in grid-like structures called crystal structures. Let us shrink the atoms to see the unit cell and the atomic bonds. This unit cell is a BCC, body-centered crystal structure, which is called so because of the atom in the middle of it. This is a very common structure in steels. Let us zoom out a bit to a connection of unit cells. Let us also change the view from 3D to 2D for simplicity. There are two ways that atoms of the alloying elements can be part of the crystal structure of the steel. The first one is substitutional. When the atoms of the alloying elements are similar in size as those of the primary metal, they replace atoms that make up the crystal structure. And the second is interstitial. It is when the atoms of the alloying element are much smaller than the atoms of the primary metal, then they are in between the atoms of the primary metal, in the interstices. In this case, these are the carbon atoms that are much smaller in diameter. Now that we have a better understanding of the steel and its alloy elements, let us go to the ion nitriding process. We will not delve too deep into the mechanics of how ion nitriding happens, but be sure to check our video on that topic as well. For this video, we will just keep to what happens to the steel and its properties. Nitriding is a diffusion process of nitrogen into the steel grade. Nitrogen atoms, similar to the carbon atoms, are smaller compared to the base metal atoms, so they diffuse into the steel through the interstices. By doing so, they are distorting the crystal structure of the material, a local positive defect that increases the hardness. This is how a cross-section of a nitrided steel and the layer look like, in most cases. The white layer. It is the topmost and the hardest part of all the nitrided layer. It is just a few microns of mainly iron nitrides, and increases the surface hardness, reduces abrasive and adhesive wear, increases the corrosion resistance, and reduces the friction coefficient of the parts. The diffusion zone. Depending on the steel grade and the process parameters, this zone can range between 10 and 800 microns or more of depth. Nitrogen is inside the crystal structure making strong bonds with iron and some of the alloy elements. This zone adds support to the surface for sustaining higher application loads and has high hardness and high fatigue strength, increasing greatly the life cycle of nitrided parts. The transition zone between diffusion zone and the core material. It is similar to the diffusion zone, but with a lot less nitrogen reaching these depths of the material. The core. Below the layer, there is the core material, which remains as before nitriding. This is very important because maintaining the core, the material remains ductile, but with enhanced hardness at the working surfaces. Let us return to our gear example, and see how the nitrided layer will look like when we make a cross-section of the gear. Some steel grades are more suitable for plasma nitriding than others and therefore will achieve better results. This is due to the alloying elements present in the steel. Some elements are better nitride formers. However, too many alloying elements might mean lower diffusion depth in the end, so a balance must be maintained. In the case of nitriding stainless steels, for example, the high percentage of chromium in the steel contributes for the high surface hardness but also stands in the way of nitrogen diffusion in depth. There are two ways to determine the nitrided layer or the case depth. total case depth and effective case depth. Both are done by measuring the hardness in depth, using most often the Vickers method. Measuring from the surface towards the core, the percentage of diffused nitrogen will fall and so we will get a lower hardness. The total case depth is measured at 50 HV on top of the core hardness. Then when measuring from the surface towards the core, the place where we reach that value is the place we say we have the total case depth. This is the place where the diffusion zone ends. The effective case depth, on the other hand, is given as standard hardness values for different steels at which the layer is fixed to end. In our case of AISI 4142, for example, the value is 395 HV of hardness. Let us look at the following example, using standard process results for our gears. We will measure a cross-section sample with Vickers, starting from the surface, and measure towards the core. Placing the marker at 395 HV, we are able to see the effective case depth. And the average core value is about 300 HV, and we add 50 HV to that, to get the place where the total case depth ends. Ion nitriding is very suitable for enhancing the surface properties of various steel components used in industries such as automotive, aerospace, tooling, and manufacturing, where increased hardness, wear resistance, and fatigue life are crucial for performance and longevity.
Ionitech. Technology, solutions, expertise.